Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and hi everyone. Today we are going to present about our group project assignment, and our group project assignment title is Ocean Plastic Pollution, and we are from group 5 session 2 for subject environmental engineering. Before I started presenting, let me introduce myself and my team members. My team consists of 4 members, which is me, Muhammad Adib bin Farouk, and second we have Muhammad Mirza bin Maslizam, and third we have Nur Balkis binti Nasaruddin, and lastly we have Nur Fasiha binti Muhammad Azizi as our group leader. For table of contents, first we have introduction, second we have objective, and third we have problem. Then we have schematic drawing, then we have discussion, and lastly we have conclusion. Ocean or marine pollution is a growing problem in today's world. Marine pollution is a combination of chemicals and trash, most of which comes from land sources and blown into the ocean. This pollution results in damage to the environment, to the health of all organisms, and to the economic structures worldwide. At first, the chemical contamination or nutrient pollution is concerning for health, environmental and economic reasons. This type of pollution occurs when human activities, notably the use of fertilizer on farms, lead to the runoff of chemicals into waterways that ultimately flow into the ocean. The increased concentration of chemicals, such as nitrogen and phosphorus, in the coastal ocean promotes the growth of algal blooms, which can be toxic to the wildlife and harmful to the humans. The negative effect on health and the environment caused by the algal blooms hurt local fishing and tourism industry. Marine trash encompasses all manufactured products, and most of them are plastic that end up in the ocean. Littering, storm winds and poor waste management all contribute to the accumulation of this debris, 80% of which come from sources on land. Plastic waste is a particularly problematic as a pollutant because it is so long lasting. Plastic items can take hundreds of years to decompose. This trash poses dangers to the humans and animals. Fish become tangled and injured in the debris, and some animals mistake items like plastic bag for food and eat them. Small organisms feed on tiny bits of broken down plastic called microplastic and absorb the chemical from the plastic into their tissues and become a cell.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello, my name is Nur Fasiha binti Muhammad Azizi. I will present objective of ocean plastic pollution. First, to identify pollution problems that result in endangered animal life. Second, to study the Malaysia community knowledge, attitude and practice on the context of uncontrolled waste disposal. Third, to study the causes of the ubiquitous garbage disposal problems that endanger the life of animals. Fourth, to study the effective solution method to solve the problem of waste deposit everywhere. The last objective, to discuss community awareness in decline with the issue of ubiquitous dumping using indicator of knowledge, impact and action.
So the problem is uncontrolled dumping of garbage. So in a recent case, the pollution of the ocean by the anti-organic litter has been recognized as a serious global environmental concern. Marine litter is defined as any persistent manufacture or processed solid material disposed or an abandoned in the marine and coastal environment. In the bracket, UNEP 2009. See, it the first mentioned in the scientific literature in the 1990s, research efforts addressing marine litter have constantly grown and has the amount of the litter in the ocean. Many studies have shown ocean pollution by the garbage consists primarily of plastics, with a continuously increasing global annual production. So, of 299 million tons plus plastic Euro 2015, it has been estimated that 10% of all plastic debris end up in the ocean. So the main reason for the accumulation of litter in the sea is, first, the increasing use of single-use products. So second is uncontrolled disposal of litter along with the poor waste management and recycling practice.
A schematic drawing. The first step to be taken is an awareness campaign through television advertisement. Advertisements air on television and disseminate on radio will give a more direct concept and picture, and people will more easily understand their role and begin to cultivate a responsible attitude in themselves. Among the campaign to protect river and the sea is the Love Our River campaign. The Love Our River campaign has done a lot of activity to clean up the river area. In this campaign, participants will be taught about the importance of caring from river and how to manage water in order to reduce the level of water pollution to a minimum. Moreover, increasing the total number of bins poor water management in residential areas are municipal residences has resulted in garbage being scarce anywhere. Therefore, rubbish bins should be added in strategic places as rubbish collection centers so that rubbish does not overflow. The third step is to change the production process to produce less water. This is by replacing the product with reusable and recyclable material to start a zero water lifestyle so that there will be less pollution to water management. Also, manufacturers can consider making new products from cardboard box or water plastic that are currently used to pack their own products. Further, by enforcing law that can be controlled arbitrary water disposal activity in the community by the authority. Among the law that can be improved further is by increasing the number of compounds that are offensive committed. In addition, it emphasizes environmental activity in the constitution and imposes appropriate punishment for offensive committed. This is because in rediscipline, the community behavior toward garbage disposal, the amount of garbage in the sea will be reduced because there will be no more garbage dumping anywhere. This can also reduce the rate of animal mortality caused by plastic water used as a food source.
Now with me again, Nofasa binti Muhammad Azizi, I will talk about discussion solution of ocean plastic pollution. The survey also found the pool waste management in residential area and municipal residences has resulted in garbage being scattered everywhere. Therefore, rubbish bin need to be added in strategy place as rubbish collection center so that rubbish do not overflow. The addition of rubbish bin also allows residents to have annual rubbish deposit site. In addition, another step that need to be taken is an awareness campaign through television advertisements. Advertisements air on the television and dissemination on radio will give a more direct concept and picture, so people will more easily understand their rules and begin to cultivate a responsible attitude in themselves. The public is also encouraged to participate the awareness campaigns. Among the campaigns that protect river and the sea is the Love Our River campaigns. For example, the Love Our River campaigns has carried many activities to clean up the river area. In the campaign, participants will be taught about the importance of caring for river and way to manage waste in the water order to reduce the level of water pollution to a minimum. The last, water pollution is very serious problem and requests the cooperation for all parties to address the problem so that we can have a clean source of water and can live with environment without water pollution. That's all for me. Thank you.
Well, firms may elect to reduce procurement costs because product packaging is one of the biggest contributors to waste. It means that manufacturers can limit their use of packaging materials to reduce the waste. Great packaging design are sometimes required to showcase the uniqueness of some items, but this does not need to investing a significant amount of money in them. To begin a zero waste lifestyle, replace the product with reusable and recyclable materials. As a result, waste management will be less polluted, and that manufacturers may also consider creating a new product from the cardboard boxes or unused polymer to package their own goods.
By enforcing the law, it can re-discipline society behavior towards garbage disposal. This causes the amount of garbage in the sea to decrease, as there will be no more garbage dumping anywhere. Besides, society will begin to have a cautious attitude in committing offenses involving the environment, such as littering. This is because the punishment imposed is heavy of a person to face. Next, it also causes the community to feel that this environmental care is very important to maintain, to give the next generation a better enjoyment of the environment. This can prevent certain species of animals and plants from become extinct.
For the conclusion or summary, we have relatively little knowledge on the amount of microplastic that enter on the ocean, as well as the processes and time scales that contribute to fragmentation and microplastic creation by the industry. So due to the physical or chemical features, there is minimal knowledge concerning the possible long-term risk of microplastics. So there is a need for assessment to follow up on the UNEP effort to compile all the relevant scientific data and provide suggestions that will be useful to the many governmental, industrial and the societal organizations with responsibilities in this area. Any assessments of microplastics must take into account the large problem of marine debris and solid waste management that has arisen as a result of the microplastic. Microplastic should be included in the new and systematic habitat monitoring programs. So particularly, national and regional disease monitoring programs. To summarize, ocean pollution is a worldwide issue that has harmed numerous animals. So it is critical to think seriously about resolving all pollution in the sea, because it's a place where marine creatures can thrive, as well as one of the humanity's most essential sources of food. So if the ocean becomes polluted or poisoned, it will have a direct negative influence on human health. So environmental awareness on a global scale, the ultimate goal is to make human life more stable and secure. So humans must now consider the value of ocean species in the globe and begin to realize that we must maintain the ocean alive in the world. So hopefully, we will see increase in the number of ocean species in the future, allowing us to sustain the ocean biodiversity. It must be done.
And that brings us to the end. I would like to thank you for your time and attention today. And I will end this presentation with Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.